This is Fiesta Fiesta, powered on KSAT 12 by your local Toyota dealers.
It is on and we are live. Welcome to the official kickoff of Fiesta 2019. Look how much this event has grown since KSAT 12 has been broadcasting Fiesta Fiesta live from Hemisphere Park.
Things are just getting started. Folks are still pouring in. This is the time when our city comes together with a party, with a purpose. We all give back to our community. And what you're looking at right now is the People's Parade.
What an event this is. The People's Parade right through the heart of Hemisphere Park. The big hats, you got the Cavaliers, it's King Antonio there. We're gonna talk to him in just a few minutes as people make their way through all the festivities and all that is Fiesta Fiesta, even our furry friends.
That's right. El Rey Fido here as well. And a lot of participating organizations. They have been getting pumped up all afternoon long. They are here for the party, and we're here to bring it to you live. Good evening, everyone. I'm Ursula Perry, and welcome to Fiesta Fiesta, our favorite party of the year.
Absolutely.
We love kicking things off, and we love that you are joining us for the biggest party in San Antonio. Obviously, this is the place to be.
And I'm Steve Spreester. Tonight, we're going to interview some of the Fiesta royalty. We're going to show you the sights and sounds here from Hemisphere Park. We're also going to talk to legendary Texas musician Ruben Ramos. We've got a lot of special guests that will come with us tonight.
But first, we're going to go right to the heart of the party. And Adam Cassie's standing by with his cañon, stirring things up in the crowd.
You know, we are having nothing but fun over here. I've moved locations from Pin Pandemonium to the Toyota area around me. A lot of activities going on. They got giveaways. We'll talk about why people are riding on this Tacoma. That'll be later on. That'll be next hour. All right, I've got Ethan Bryant here with me. Ethan Bryant plays for San Antonio FC. All right, so Ethan, tell me what y'all are doing down here at this Toyota area, this Fiesta.
Yeah, so it's Fiesta, as you can see, and we're here signing autographs, you know, saying hi to all the community, and, you know, we're having a blast.
Doing the old Fiesta thing, basically.
Yeah, so we're loving it.
So tell me about this medal here, first of all.
Okay, so this medal you can get at sbgb.org, and it all goes to the Silver and Black Give Back organization, which is a nonprofit run by the Spurs Sports and Entertainment. It gives back to kids through sports and service. So it's a really cool medal that I would definitely pick up.
I'm assuming you can get them at your next game, is that right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, we'll talk about that in a second, but first I want to get to this one as well. Now, this is Toyota's special one this year. Very beautiful. I love the gold colors and even the gold glitter where it says Viva. And notice the matching, there you go. Matching piñata. That is fantastic. All right, so you are from San Antonio. So tell me what it feels like to be in a different role in Fiesta.
Yeah, so this environment's very familiar to me. I love it. I've grown up and I know all about it. So it's really nice to be out here and, you know, be a kind of a little bit of a celebrity. So
all right, next game?
Next game, we have an away game in Salt Lake. Home game is here against the Tacoma Defiance. And so make sure and come out, support.
Is that going to be next week?
Two weekends.
At Toyota Field. All right. Yep. Ethan Bryant, San Antonio FC. Yeah. We're going to have more fun, and we're going to tell you why people are riding on this Tacoma coming up next hour.
Yeah. All right. Thank you, Adam. Thank you with your special guest there live from the Toyota area of Fiesta Fiesta.
And we have another wonderful host joining us from in the middle of all the fun. Our Katie Blake is standing by with Chick-fil-A. Hey, Katie.
Hey, guys. All right. Food is such a huge part of Fiesta. And when you think good food, good chicken, I don't know about you, but I think about Chick-fil-A. I'm here with Joshua Cunningham. He's with Chick-fil-A. And this is the fourth year that you guys have partnered with Fiesta, right?
It is. This is our fourth year, loving our community, serving some great food. We've got some great music going on. This is always one of our favorite events of the year, and we're so happy to partner with the Fiesta Commission.
This is so much fun. So we've got the cows out here We've got some music. You guys are having a good time.
The mariachis have been amazing. The cows have been dancing. We're here celebrating Fiesta with about, 5,000 of our closest friends and families. So we're having a grand time. We want to invite all of San Antonio to come out. We're giving away our delicious Chick-fil-A nuggets, one of our hero products. In fact, I'm going to make sure that you do get some nuggets. I got some nuggets right
thank
here for you. We've got
you.
Incredible sauces you can dip them in. So we're really just here to serve our community and have a great time.
And Chick-fil-A has a mobile kitchen, right?
Yes, we've got the mobile kitchen behind us. We're giving away nuggets today. We've got two other events coming up.
Okay.
We'll be giving out 8,000 sandwiches to the community free of charge. So be sure to stop by and get some chicken.
Yes, 8,000 sandwiches. So we're going to check back in with Joshua and Chick-fil-A here later on in the show, because there's something, if you are a fan of Chick-fil-A sauce, like if you don't ever get as much sauce as you want, they've got something really great for you during Fiesta. So we're going to talk to Joshua all about that and check back in with all the fun over here coming up later on in the show. Guys, back to you.
All right, thank you, Katie. Joining us right now, King Antonio the 97th, Roger C. Hill the 3rd. Thank you for joining us.
I got to say that I'm so excited because on Monday is that first event of the River Parade, and I am loving the idea that there's new things with the River Parade again this year.
Yes, we're so excited for Monday night. Look forward to seeing everybody along the way.
All right, hold on 1 second. The microphone's not working. So, of course, we get started and the microphone's not working. They've got another one they're going to hand off to you. Here, let's try this one. All right, give me a test, Roger.
How's that one working for you?
All right, we're going to do this. I'm going to talk to you like this. Talk about the River Parade coming up on Monday.
We're looking forward to the River Parade on Monday night. We're looking forward to seeing everybody along the riverbanks. We've got Leon Coffey serving as our Grand Marshal. Yeah. We're so excited about that. The theme of the River Parade this year is it's showtime in San Antonio. And from the River Parade, we're able to give back to our community, which is our biggest fundraiser. Allow us to give over $1.5 million away to children's charities this year.
You've been involved with the Cavaliers for a long time. What's it like to be King Antonio?
It's a lot of fun. I've been in the Cavaliers since 2003. I was parade marshal in 2015. It's just fun and so rewarding to give back to our community, especially going to all these schools and different charities we visit. It's very humbling and very rewarding.
We're so happy to see Leon Coffey. I have to tell you, this is a very unique River Parade marshal for us this year.
It is. We're looking forward to Leon all dressed up in his garb like he's in the rodeo, and it's going to be a fun night. We're looking forward to it.
You've got the dynamic duo, too, because you've got Leon Coffey, who's, you know, the Grand Marshal, and you've got Morgan's Wonderland. That's the charity that's benefiting this year.
That's correct. So Morgan's Wonderland's our charitable honoree. We're going to donate to them more than $850,000 this year.
Wow.
So it's a big deal for us, and we're glad to give back to our community, and especially such a deserving charity like Morgan's Wonderland.
Thank you so much, King Antonio. It's a pleasure to have you here.
And I'm glad. It's a pleasure to share a mic with you, King.
There you go. That is the closest you're ever going to get to being royalty.
That is as close as I'm going to be in royalty.
Sorry, Steve.
With my medal, too, as well. Special medal.
Oh,
thank you.
I'll take one of those.
And the King's medal right there. Awesome.
Yes, and I want to mention that we're also going to be live at that River Parade right here on KSAT 12 on Monday night.
We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back at Fiesta, Fiesta 2019.
And 2019 Fiesta San Antonio.
Welcome back. Fiesta, Fiesta 2019.
You are looking at the main stage here at Fiesta, Fiesta, where Mike Osterhage and Jen Strusky are the master and mistress of ceremonies. We've got the military ambassadors that are about to open up Fiesta for 2019.
And, you know, the military is such a huge part of the city and of Fiesta. I think it's just fitting that they recognize the military ambassadors and the different groups that are here in San Antonio, just such a big part of the fabric of this city.
And this city just comes alive over these next 2 weeks. And, you know, the people who go all out for weeks, if not months, creating their costumes and their hats, they're all here today as well. We've got so many different organizations who are really counting on Fiesta to make a difference in their bottom line. For some of them, Fiesta means a year's worth of operating expenses for their nonprofit. So we're really happy to be able to bring you Fiesta, Fiesta and show you the start of the party.
And that's the thing that I get every time that we come down here, Ursula, is just what a privilege it is to be part of this event and, you know, to be able to bring people it right into their living rooms, into what's happening right in the heart of downtown San Antonio. And you saw Jen and Mike there earlier, and people with their cameras, people walking behind us where we're a little bit farther into Hemisphere Park, people walking by still exchanging medals.
Yes.
And pin pandemonium as this whole thing continues.
And coming up in just a little while, we're going to be having some live entertainment. We're going to bring that to you live. And, of course, we have that spectacular fireworks celebration from the Tower of the Americas, something you don't want to miss.
And right now, I believe our Mike Osterhage and Jen Strusky are on stage. Let's listen in.
Tommy Band, 35 to Nowhere, is going to play some more music for you. Viva Fiesta, guys.
All right. They just walked off the stage. We're waiting for the military ambassadors to also take the stage. And these military ambassadors, I actually got the chance to meet them earlier, a couple weeks ago. They had a Fiesta Media Day, and I got a chance to meet each of the members of the military ambassadors. They're from each of the different armed services, and there was only one of them from San Antonio. So for all the rest of the ambassadors, this is the first time they've experienced Fiesta in the way that they're going to experience Fiesta over the next couple of weeks.
And another important point, most people don't realize that a lot of the royal courts and the royal organizations, but also the military ambassadors, make it to every single event.
Yes.
They will RSVP and say, we will be there, and I promise you they will. And sometimes it's not just one or two, it's like 16, 20.
Right, and they're also in the parades.
Right.
They're also in each of the parades, of course. The first one is going to be the Cavaliers River Parade coming up on Monday. And right now, the U.S. Army Band has taken the stage. Let's listen in a little bit to the band.
Razzling and dazzling, a flash of little light. Television lover, baby, go all night. Sometime, anytime, sugar me sweet. Little Miss Innocent, sugar me. Yeah! So come on.
Welcome back, KSAT 12, right in the middle of the biggest party in town tonight. And we have a variety of events that we're going to feature. You're going to meet Fiesta Royalty. You've already met King Antonio tonight. And we're going to dance along with some live music as well.
And pretty soon, as the sun goes down, we've got a show in the sky we're going to bring you. Fireworks are going to be lighting up downtown at the end of our show. About 15 minutes to 9 is when we're told that's going to happen. Meantime, we're going to take you back down to Pin Pandemonium as folks continue to enjoy absolutely perfect evening weather-wise.
I got to tell you, I love this wind because it's not hard to tell where Adam Caskey is. You just look for the flying confetti. He joins us live right now from Pin Pandemonium. Adam.
Yes, Steve Ursula. The wind has subsided a bit, but I still have got it down. You play the wind with the confetti. We're here at Pin Pandemonium. Look at all those medals. We're all sporting our medals, people trading medals, getting new medals. But it's not really a party until we have some confetti. All right, gonna get pressurized here. I think this will be worth maybe 70 PSI or so. That'll be about right. All right, I'm gonna play the wind, okay? So I'm gonna step this way. All right. And I need a countdown. So we're gonna go 3, 2, 1, Viva Fiesta, okay?
Ready, here we go.
And I'm ready. 3, 2, 1, Viva! falling for the next.
See how far that confetti's flying in the sky down here at Hemisphere?
Everybody is taking Facebook videos watching that confetti fly. And, you know, it's not Fiesta without Adam Caskey's version of Fiesta.
It is not.
He has certainly created his own, you know, his own special moment that San Antonio will never forget.
That is for sure. And as all this is unfolding, there is, of course, as we said, the U.S. Army Band from the 323rd U.S. Army Band on stage. I believe they're playing a little something from The Police right now.
Let's listen. Yeah.
Mend your life, but love can break your heart. Message in a bottle. Message in a bottle. Message in a bottle.
About the military ambassadors and how big a part the military plays in Fiesta. A few weeks ago, I got a chance to meet the military ambassadors, young people from across the country, and for many of them, this is their very first Fiesta.
Tell me where you're from.
San Antonio, Texas.
Love it.
Vancouver, Washington.
Fort Lee, New Jersey.
Sunny San Diego, California.
San Jose, California.
Tampa, Florida.
AL, Hawaii.
New Orleans, Louisiana.
New Orleans, Louisiana.
We're the military ambassadors. Viva Fiesta!
KSAT 12 giving a tribute to all the military ambassadors and personalities you'll see during the Fiesta events.
This is my first Fiesta experience. So being a part of this whole medal exchange, I'm like, this is really cool. It's really awesome.
Where are you from?
I'm from New Jersey originally.
They don't have Fiesta in New Jersey?
They do not have Fiesta.
It's a party with a purpose, and it takes hundreds of hardworking volunteers and personalities who work throughout the year to make Fiesta an event we all enjoy.
What does this experience tell you about San Antonio?
The rich history, the support system that everybody puts, you know, into for this whole event that's happening, and it's a total span of 10 days. I think it's amazing. It really is. So, I mean, so far it's been great. It's been an honor to be a part of this.
Thank you to our Fiesta military ambassadors and to all military members serving our country.
That's awesome. And, you know, the coolest thing, like I said a little bit earlier, is that there are so many Fiesta events going on right now, and they are going to hit all of them. You will see them at just about every official Fiesta event. They'll call RSVP, say, we promise we'll be there, and they show up, and you get to host them, which is, again, another part of Fiesta, being a host to some folks that you really appreciate.
Yeah, and absolutely. And the thing we learned from that interview is they do not have Fiesta in New Jersey. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to Fiesta Fiesta. You know, since KSAT 12 has begun broadcasting live from Fiesta Fiesta, this has really grown into an impressive event. It is a jam-packed event every single year. This year, of course, with the weather this nice, it's no exception. And tonight you're going to meet some of the Fiesta royalty. You're also going to meet the queens, who are making a big difference in our community. And they're going to take part in the Cascarone break that's going to occur in just a few minutes on the main stage.
Yeah, and the cutting of the ugly tie, all of that.
Very
part
important,
of what's going to happen.
Important.
Yeah, let's go check in with our Katie Blake right now, who is out and about, I believe, in the Chick-fil-A area.
With the Dancing Cows.
Hey, guys. Yeah, we're still hanging out with Chick-fil-A. And I don't know about you, okay, but when I think, you know, food and Fiesta events, it generally doesn't involve mariachi music. We have a great setup right here. There's a Chick-fil-A stage. The mobile kitchen is back there. There's a line over there. You see those big sauce packets? There's a line over there where you could go get little packets of nuggets, samples of food. So this is definitely a great setup for Fiesta that Chick-fil-A has here. They're also doing some giveaways. You can get some cards that will get you a free meal at any of their restaurants. And also, of course, a little Chick-fil-A cow. So there's a lot going on here. And next hour, we're going to be back with Joshua of Chick-fil-A, who's going to tell us more about what you can expect from Chick-fil-A for the rest of Fiesta, because they're going to be out at different events sampling food. And you heard him just a few minutes ago, they'll be giving out 8,000 sandwiches over the course of Fiesta, so that's a lot of food. And we'll talk to him again coming up in just a bit. Back to you guys.
The U.S. Army Band is still rocking it all on the main stage. In just a few minutes, we're going to have, again, all the traditions of Fiesta, the start of Fiesta. You know, you gotta do it right every single year.
You gotta do it right, absolutely. And it looks like the U.S. Army Band is wrapping up for the night. And of course, our Mike Osterhage and Jen Strusky will take the stage after that when we get some of the traditions that we've been talking about and the official kickoff of Fiesta. Right now, let's check in with our Adam Caskey, who, you know, I guess an unofficial tradition has to be the Cañon de Cascuron.
Completely original, Adam.
You know, it's all about the medals in this area in Pin Pandemonium. All about the medals. So, different vantage point. Katie was back behind me. There you have the Chick-fil-A stage where we had the mariachis. Now, look down here. All the way down this whole sidewalk, which leads you basically to Yanaguana Park area and whatnot. Look at this, the river of people that has been flowing through here. And it's all about the medals. All right, we're going to do some selfies. We're going to do some pictures. Steve Ursula, back to you. Viva Fiesta!
Viva Fiesta!
All right, thank you, Adam. Let's go to the stage right now and listen in to Mike and Jen.
Gonzalez! Lerena de la Feria de las Flores, Montana, Roden, Kielbasa. Charo Queen, Victoria Rodriguez. Fiesta Teenage Queen, Kendall Keller.
Queen of Soul, Raylan Brown. And Miss San Antonio, Rebecca Mendoza.
All right, Fiesta Tradition dedicates that the next 10 days of merriment and official business attire gives way to chanclas and guayaberas to officially commemorate 10 days of Fiesta frolic. Though we had some great Fiesta events already happen, so we stretched the fun a little longer. Now it's time for the cutting of the tie and the breaking of the cascarón. All right, on stage now, we have Fiesta Commission President Byron LaFleur. Mayor Ron Nuremberg. And his two celebrities. Joining us on stage is the San Antonio Chamber of Commerce President Richard Perez. And Paula Gold-William, Board Chair and CEO of CPS Energy and President of San Antonio Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, Diane Sanchez. And Chief Operations Officer, Brianna Dimas. Mayor. There you go.
Viva! Hey, did y'all know that tonight is game 3 of that series with the Spurs and the Nuggets? So I got a call from Mayor Michael Hancock in Denver. He said it was going to be Nuggets in 5. What do we think about that? I told him that, you know, they played pretty well, but the Spurs and Fiesta are an annual tradition, and that we're going to take care of business. Is that right? Let's get it. Go Spurs, go!
Go Spurs, go! Go Spurs, go! Go Spurs, go!
But thank you all for coming out. Fiesta 2019, this is a party with a purpose. We get to have a lot of fun, but we get to do it to better our community. Thank you all. Viva Fiesta! Viva, Viva San Antonio!
All right, folks, you know what to do. Everybody get in place for the breaking of the Coscarón and the cutting of the tie. Everybody get together, right up front, front and center. Okay, is everybody ready? We're going to count you down, so we need everybody to count, starting at five, counting backwards. Are you ready?
All right, here we go. In five, four, three, two, one.
We get sharper scissors. All right, Fiesta participants. You know what time it is. Time to show your shoes because you're going to be rocking the streets. Let's see the shoes, everybody. Thank you all very much. And again, everybody, one, two, three. Viva Fiesta! Hey, you know what? You know what time I think it is? Time for a selfie. Ready? Everybody smile, because this is going to be on then SA Live, okay? Everybody ready? Everybody got to say Viva Fiesta on three. One, two, three. Now, everybody turn around and take a selfie this way. Or not. And Mayor, your favorite part about Fiesta is?
The turkey legs and the cascarones.
Sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
All right.
And there you have it.
And what's the score going to be tonight?
It is official, Steve. The Fiesta has officially opened up the celebration for the next couple of weeks.
I don't think it's official yet.
Why not?
There. Now, oh, yeah? Now it's official. Okay. Turnabout is fair play.
Oh,
yeah.
Yes.
And they had a little trouble with the tie there. Did you notice that?
Somebody didn't sharpen those scissors.
The mayor's ugly tie. By the way, the whole tie thing goes back to the fact that Fiesta is relaxed. It should be about chanclas, guayaberas. It should not be. See, I know I got.
He's got his chanclas on, and he's got his guayabera.
It should not be about ties,
and he's
ugly or nice.
I brought a lot of Coscarones.
They seem to have a lot of confetti in them. Like extra large ones, or I mean, what's the deal here? Seems like they got a lot of confetti in them.
I talked to Adam Caskey. He said we were going to have a lot of wind tonight, and because of that, we need to have lots of confetti because the wind. Oh, okay. Hey, Adam, have you had any cascarones cracked over your head yet?
You know, I'm just kind of dancing with my cañon right now, you know, do a little two-step with the cañon. Why not? Hey, where's the energy, people? All right, people have been asking for some confetti, more confetti. I can't believe it. They just keep asking because The more Fetty, the better. You want some Fetty? But are you ready for some Fetty? Oh, these boys down here want some confetti. They want some confetti. I love your outfits. You guys look awesome. Can you say Viva Fiesta to everybody?
Viva Fiesta.
That was awesome. High five. Can I get a high five? All right, do you guys want to see some confetti go way high in the sky? Like super high, super duper high. Okay, you ready? Oh yeah, do you see it in there? All right, I'm gonna give this to our cameraman. All right, ready? Can you help me count down? 3, 2, 1. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Viva Fiesta, buddies! Yeah, you got a little on you there. It's okay.
All right, I love that. Look at those precious guys with their haircuts.
Absolutely
ready to go.
Precious. All right. Well, we are standing by. Oop! I'm losing my flowers here.
It's a little windy.
It's a little windy out here. But coming up in just a few minutes, we're going to talk to El Rey Feo is in the house, and we can't wait to talk to him about his program as well.
Fiesta rolls on. We'll be right back. Official. Fiesta 2019 is official. We broke the Cascarones just a little bit ago. We cut the ugly tie.
Twice.
We have El Rey Feo with us.
Yes.
It's all good.
Yes, we have Dr. Sal Barbero, who has the best medals in town, as well as La Reina de las Flores, who is Montana Kielbasa. And we couldn't be happier to have you here on the show. It's not Fiesta without you guys.
It's an honor to be here, you know. Just a great evening. Great weather, thank you, God, and it's great here to be with this lovely lady in Montana, the Fetty Las Flores Queen.
Yes, I'm so happy that we get to spread the joy of education and get to be here and see everyone. So it's been an awesome night so far.
I love what you have to say about what comes first, what comes second, and what comes third in your life. Your message: God first, family second, then education and career.
Right, it's always God first, and everything you do, it's always God first. Christian man, I attend Community Bible Church, great church, and out there to serve the Lord. And what a better time, you know, we're getting ready for Good Friday. We all have to remember where we are and who we need to really thank for our lives, don't we?
I also want to talk about your crown.
Yeah.
A unique crown, a heart right in the center. That's not by accident.
No, it's not by accident. I mean, it's kind of like a dual heart. I'm a cardiologist, but also,
yes,
you know, I have a heart for the people here of San Antonio. They've just welcomed me. I'm so, you know, it's just an amazing thing to be here in San Antonio. Spurs are playing tonight. Can't ask for even a better thing, and just a great thing.
Absolutely.
And Montana, we understand that not only do you wear this crown, but you also just made a movie?
Yes, I did. It's called Teenage Girl Valerie's Holiday. So it's going to be coming out in August.
Yeah. What is it called again?
Teenage Girl Valerie's Holiday.
Okay.
Yes. So the point of the movie is to promote standing up against bullying, which has been my message when we go and talk to the elementary school kids.
And what an important right. message,
yes,
too.
Yes.
Yeah.
How wonderful. And as I'm the mother of two children who have heart conditions, and so I have great value for cardiologists. But as a father, though, you also have 7 children?
Yes, we have 7 children. We're blessed to have 7 children. The Lord blessed us. And you know, it's, you learn a lot as they, you know, as you go from one to the other, you know. Right, yeah. Adopted this girl.
She's
fantastic. I mean, it's, you know, it's great. And, you know, our mission here for the Rey Feo Scholarship Organization and Foundation, Consejo Organization, is to raise money for kids who can't afford to go to school. This year we raised over about $300,000 for those scholarships we'll hand out on August 9th. It's great to see, you know, those kids when they come up to the stage and they have that big smile on their face. And you know, it's just no greater thing than that. And then Montana has every school we visited. We visited over 50 or 60 schools somewhere in there, nursing home, children's hospitals. And every time I go there, they just light. They light up when they see Montana, don't they?
They love you, though. They love you, though.
What do you learn when you go to these schools?
Honestly, I've learned so much just to see the children and how much they appreciate you and just coming in and they want to listen and hear about education. And then when you get them excited, I've been saying, be humble, be kind. That's what I've been trying to spread throughout the schools. And they really listen to that and really want to try and understand that. So it's been such an amazing opportunity and feeling. Like I'm so thankful that we got the opportunity to do
this. You talked about bullying being a big part of why did you choose that as your main focus?
Because it happens a lot in elementary school, and whenever bullying happens, it keeps kids from wanting to continue their education. They don't want to come to school anymore. They don't want to get out of bed. And so I think it's so, so important to stand up against bullying and to spread that message so that kids do want to get up in the morning and they want to wake up with a smile on their face and go to class and have fun and have friends. Like,
and I think they look at you and they say, a princess is talking to us about bullying. I mean, if she's been bullied, then I'm not alone.
Right, exactly. It just, that is like such a big message to let them know that they're not alone and that we want to listen to them and we hear them and we understand and that we're here and that's why we're spreading that message.
Yeah.
A very timely message. We thank you guys so much for joining us. You are a glittering part of Fiesta. You brighten up any stage you're on, and we are honored to have had you today.
It's our honor to be here with you guys.
Thank you very much. All right, our Katie Blake is out and about. Let's check in with Katie, I believe, still with Dancing Cows.
Spot, I mean, it is getting very Fiesta-ish over here.
Oh, yeah.
There's a party going on over here. And when you think Chick-fil-A, you think good chicken, right? But you also think of the cow. And the Fiesta Cow is very special this year, right, John?
Absolutely. Our Fiesta Cow, you know, Chick-fil-A, we love San Antonio so much. We got our own Fiesta medals here with our little Fiesta Cow right here saying, como mas pollo. And, of course, we got our Fiesta Cow out here having a great time, dancing to some salsa. We are just having a party out here.
I love the medals this year because they are complete with cowboy boots. Absolutely. On the cow, and that's awesome. So how can folks buy one of the medals, and what do part of the proceeds go to?
Yeah, so you can stop by tonight. We're handing out some medals here, but you can also purchase them locally in each Chick-fil-A restaurant while supplies last. They're $7.99, and percentage of the proceeds actually go to local schools and nonprofits. So Wonderful. Be sure to go out there and get your Chick-fil-A Fiesta medal.
Now, looking ahead to the rest of Fiesta, you guys are going to have Como Mas Pollo, you're going to have more medals to give away and more food, right?
More food, lots of food. Our goal is to give out over 8,000 sandwiches in the next couple of days, so be sure to come out here, check us out. We're excited to be here and love on our community.
It will be really easy to find Chick-fil-A because there's going to be very loud music and a whole lot of dancing, and that's what we have going on. The conga line has formed.
Oh, absolutely. In fact, I'm going to have to leave here pretty soon to go join that conga line.
So. You should go. Thank you, Joshua. All right. From Chick-fil-A, the cow, the good food over here, we'll send it back to you guys. Check in with you soon.
All right, we are back in the heart of Hemisphere, and they got us off the stage. I'm kind of happy about that.
Well, it was a little tight up there, and I was getting worried.
You thought I was going to fall off? Well, no, we're good.
Well, coming up, we're going to have an even bigger group of guests, and we want to make sure that we are all safe on the stage. So, okay, so we've met some kings of Fiesta.
Yes.
We've met at least one queen, but
yes.
Now we're going to get an opportunity to meet a whole bunch of official queens this year. They are intelligent. They are bright. They give back to the community. They're changing lives. A bunch of talented young ladies. Let's meet them.
Meet La Reina de la Feria de las Flores. Montana is majoring in journalism at UT Austin.
But I would really love to bring awareness to mental illness because there's a lot of different illnesses that people aren't aware of and people have a lot of misconceptions about them. So I want to make sure to really bring a larger awareness to that.
She's also starring in a movie that was filmed right here in San Antonio.
I do love film acting, and so I'm actually doing a movie right now called Teenage Girl, Valerie's Holiday. Make sure to check it out. It's coming out.
Meet the 50th Queen of Soul for 2019.
Well, I'm originally from San Antonio, Texas. I pursued my academic career in Virginia, so I moved there in 2011. I matriculated in biology, and I'm an aspiring orthopedic surgeon, so I really have love for the human anatomy and just helping people.
As a role model, she is encouraging young men and women to pursue their dreams.
Our organization is mainly for uplifting the community, whether you are Black, white, or Hispanic, but more importantly, focusing on the Black community because there's a lot of stereotypes that we do face, and I want to be that positive example.
Meet Miss San Antonio 2019.
I'm actually born and raised here in San Antonio. I attended Incarnate Word High School and went on to pursue my bachelor's and master's degrees in accounting at Southern New Hampshire University.
She is breaking barriers through dance and volunteering to help kids in our community.
I run a nonprofit that I started at 17 years old, so 8 years ago, and it's called the Community Connection Warriors. The CC Warriors was essentially built to bridge that gap between special needs and general ed. And what's so great about us is that we get to perform at a San Antonio Spurs game. So sometimes these schools are in high poverty areas and they wouldn't have the opportunity to experience the performing arts.
Meet the Charo Queen of 2019. She's taking the reins in her family, continuing their Charo dynasty.
So not just being the first queen of the family, but knowing that my grandpa's been there since 1951 and he's just one of the oldest members and has been passed down. So my dad's a member, my uncle's a member, my uncle on my mom's side used to be a member, and so my parents have met that way.
As a talented photographer, she enjoys capturing the traditions of her culture and family traditions. Meet the Teen Queen of 2019. She's a hardworking young lady who has a strong advocacy for teens in the workforce.
I work four seasonal jobs. So I'm a basketball referee and I'm the youngest female. There's about 170 officials in the chapter, and of that 170, there's only 15 women, and I'm the only one that's under the age of 25. So I'm one of the youngest and I'm one of the only women.
Meet Miss Fiesta San Antonio 2019. As Miss Fiesta San Antonio, she's dedicated to her community project, providing health items to children across San Antonio.
And the idea behind my project is to connect children who are identified within communities and schools programs and connect them with resources and education about healthy habits and healthy hygiene habits and things that people really don't think about, but they don't really have access to. So it's about not only giving them those resources in the idea that we call Boost Box, it's a really fun way to give it to them, but also educating them on why it's important.
To tell you, I think El Rey Feo and I are probably the luckiest two guys to be standing here. Not only because we're surrounded by beauty, but also brains and big hearts. Yeah,
it's wonderful to meet all of these wonderful women who have done so much for our community already and have plans to do so much more. We're really privileged to have them all represented, really for the very first time on our Fiesta stage. This is the first for us as well.
It is, absolutely. Talk a little bit about what this experience has been like for you.
It is so surreal. I wanted to become Miss San Antonio for 5 years, so after this 5 years, finally accomplishing one of my goals has been truly a dream come true. So just being able to connect with the community, really see all the organizations that are part of Fiesta has been truly eye-opening, and it makes me so great to be part of San Antonio.
Yeah.
I am so impressed by many of your platforms, including you, Miss Fiesta, the idea that you're boosting self-confidence and self-image among the children of San Antonio by simply collecting hygiene items. It's pretty amazing.
Thank you. So I'm so grateful to serve as Miss Fiesta and to be able to implement my citywide community service project with the help of communities and schools. And like you said, it's to help boost self-esteem through the education of healthy habits. And so we're giving out these boost boxes full of brand name, full size hygiene items to middle school students in San Antonio.
It's really amazing. I also am really impressed by the Charo Queen, Victoria Rodriguez. She rides side saddle. Something I've never tried to do.
You've not done that? I thought you were going to say because you've done it, and that's why you're impressed by it.
I'd be so afraid, but you'll teach me one day?
Yes.
Okay, you promise?
Yes.
All right.
All right, so what's the secret?
I mean, it's just like going up there and just being like calm and like, because the horses can like sense your energy, so you have to like keep calm and just pretend like it's a bike or something. Like,
keep calm and be a Charo Queen.
Now did I see that you're an official? Like you're a referee?
Yes, I'm
games.
A state certified basketball official. So I ref high school and junior high games.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was looking for a whistle somewhere in your outfit. I didn't see that.
No, so no. Left it at home.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We throw coats out of the game all the time.
There you go.
Yeah. And we also have the Queen of Soul here. I'm going to reach all the way over there. I know you're excited to be here today.
I am.
Yes, ma'am. So originally, my name is Raylene, but our organization is Queen of Soul. So more importantly, we are individuals who uplift the community through education. I'm more than just a queen who's for rhythm and just being able to dance. I'm somebody who inspires individual young men and women to be greater with hope and confidence. So education is key. Continue to be great. Continue to have the knowledge, because without the knowledge, you lack the proper education to get you to where you need to be.
Truly inspirational.
Thank you.
All of the queens here today. Really an honor to stand among you all.
I like this tradition. I think we should keep this going. Every fiesta, we need to have the queens on. You guys think that's good? All right, you're good with that?
Okay. All right,
yeah.
Thank you so much for being here and enjoying what they're doing, and please support their individual projects if you can.
We're gonna take a quick break. We'll be right back. Welcome back to KSAT 12's live coverage of Fiesta live from Hemisphere Park. It's been quite an event so far.
It has, and people are still pouring in. I don't know if you can see behind us. There is a huge crowd. They're continuing to pour toward the main stage, and they're really in for a really fun Fiesta night. Right now, we've got more live music going on the stage, and we're going to have, in a little while, as soon as the sun goes down, we're going to have a beautiful fireworks display from the Tower of the Americas.
It should be great, and we have a lot of things that we have planned to come up. I know that we have our Katie Blake, our Adam Caskey are out and about, and music, also a big part of San Antonio, of course, and also this event.
Yeah, mariachis in particular. They call themselves the Mariachi Corazón de San Antonio, and they are seen performing. They've been performing on Main Plaza and throughout our city, and tonight as well.
This is the true heart of the city, Main Plaza.
I'm about to go Facebook Live. We're ready? Mariachi Corazón de San Antonio. Ay, ay, ay,
ay, viva Jalisco. In the United States, mariachi capital is San Antonio, Texas. Mariachi Corazón and Main Plaza go amazingly well together.
I didn't think that this was going on today. And I saw the music instruments, the costumes, and I said, uh-oh, I'm ready for some music.
We usually play at Main Plaza, like it says on our moños, because Main Plaza is our home. It's an all-star group, and it consists of only high school kids. People come from all over, different schools, different districts, to come and compete to win a spot in our group, and only the best of the best are able to play with us.
They are the most prestigious high school group in San Antonio. Our rehearsals are intense.
She can be tough. When I first entered, she was definitely tough on us, only because she wanted to bring out the best in us. In 1 month, we're required to learn, let's say, like 12 different musics. And it's not some easy music, it's concert music, and it's very difficult.
They do everything like an all-state orchestra or choir or symphony does. It's street opera. They do everything that they do, only they're memorized and standing up. And they are true ambassadors for the city of San Antonio.
I get to share my talent. I get to sing to people. Like, it's my job, and it's amazing that I get to do what I love every day.
Yeah, I love it.
Mariachis to live music, and tonight we're also going to have legendary Texas musician and singer of Ruben Ramos. He's going to be taken to the stage.
The band La Dez is on stage right now. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back.
watching the official kickoff of Fiesta Fiesta here at Hemisphere Park. As you know, KSAT 12 is the only station broadcasting all of the parades live.
I love each and every one of the parades. They all have their different unique feel and certain things that people love about them. And, you know, it doesn't matter which one you go to or if you go to all three. They're all special.
That's right. We're going to be at the Fiesta Flambeau, and this year they have a very special theme. It is Reflections of Music Past, and that's what Toyota is doing. They are actually reflecting on your favorite music within the signature Tacoma truck.
Yeah, and now you and your favorite song will have a chance to roll through the parade, jamming the whole way, our Jen Strusky explains.
Viva Fiesta and Viva Fiesta Tacoma. We are here at the Pearl Stables to celebrate the official vehicle of Fiesta. Toyota, of course, is here. This is the 11th year that Toyota has provided the Fiesta vehicle. The Tacoma is built right here in San Antonio on a plant over on the south side by my old stomping ground, Southwest High School. And joining me today, Doug Klein, District Sales Manager of Gulf States Toyota, who's going to tell us what makes this particular vehicle so special. Because, first of all, it's beautiful, so colorful, yes, and vibrant. And yes, let's talk about what's going on this year with the Tacoma.
Well, good morning. So the Tacoma we have behind us, we're going to have ask people to come and sign it. And to go along with the theme of the parade, music reflections from the past. So what we're doing is having people come and sign with a highlighter. We got some neon lights we're going to have, black light. Ooh. During the parade. So as they're going through the parade, you'll be able to see everyone's signatures. And
that's awesome. So they'll all be glowing.
Yes, glowing very brightly, hopefully very vivid, just like Viva Fiesta. And our Tacoma here is going to be pulling a float.
Oh, okay. Yes. So the Flambeau Parade is coming up on the 27th. And what else can we expect to see from Toyota out there?
So we have six great stores here in town, and each store is donating two vehicles for the parade to pull some floats. And what we'll have, they do them up pretty well. So it'll be exciting to watch and see how customized the trucks can get. And they'll be pulling floats, or they'll just be driving along in the parade. But this one specifically is going to be pulling a float where you can go to KSAT.com and register to be a part of the float.
Okay, so how do you go about registering for all of that? Because that's exciting. People get to be, yeah, on the float. They get a chance for that.
Yeah, so during all the Fiesta activities leading up to the parade, we have on-site activations. And during the activations, you can come. Maybe you can get one of these cool medals, and you can sign up there.
Oh, or yes, very nice.
We can go to your website and just fill out the form online.
Got it. All right, well, so I think I need to sign right now.
Yes.
And by the way, Tacoma was my first vehicle in college, so
yes,
I love Tacomas. So we're going to sign here. And then the song, is it a song?
Yes,
you
your
like,
favorite or song.
Ooh, Girl
or
on Fire, Girl on Fire, yes.
There you go.
Girl on Fire. Gotta love my Alicia Keys. All right.
Perfect.
So again, this will all light up, and you,
yes,
can win a chance to be on the float, right?
Absolutely.
Awesome. So for your chance to win a ride on the Toyota float that will be pulled by this Tacoma right here, just go online to KSAT.com. Click on the Toyota logo and register for your chance to win. Doug, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Can I take it for a ride?
Later today.
I love that idea.
Oh, and by, yeah. What a fantastic opportunity.
I don't know if you saw this, but these are the Toyota medals. I was hoping they'd have a Tundra on there, but instead they have a little pinata. Pinata instead of a Tundra.
Very cool. Now,
yeah,
to
but
ride
still very
in
cool
the Fiesta Flambeau Parade, again, all you have to do is go to KSAT.com/Fiesta and click on the Fiesta Zone.
Let's go live now to our Adam Caskey, who also has a very special guest in the Toyota Zone.
You know, we are at the Toyota area, having a good time, a good crowd around here, this Tacoma behind us. We're going to talk about this in a moment, but first, I am with royalty. Miss Fiesta San Antonio 2019, Victoria Gonzalez. Round of applause. Let's hear it for her. So, Miss Gonzalez, tell me, what kind of project earned you this title?
Right. So, Miss Fiesta is underneath the Fiesta Commission. She is part of the official royalty of Fiesta, and she serves as an ambassador to Fiesta, but she is selected, or I was selected, based on my citywide community service project. So my project is working with Communities and Schools of San Antonio. It's such an amazing nonprofit, and our concept is called the Boost Box. And so the Boost Box is a cute cardboard box. It's full of brand name, full-size hygiene items that we're working to distribute to middle school students across San Antonio.
You're taking care of it. I love it. All right, let's show us the medal really quickly.
My official medal that you can buy at the Fiesta store. It has a little bit about Miss Fiesta on the back, and this is the back.
So beautiful. Now, this tundra behind us, we must sign this because they're using these special glow-in-the-dark Sharpies, and they're going to be black lighting this during the Flambeau Parade, and you can see your signatures and your favorite Fiesta memories. Now, my favorite memory every year, popping confetti. Who's ready for some fetti? Three, two, one!
What an amazing young lady and an amazing opportunity, and I love that cannon.
I do too, especially as night falls here in downtown San Antonio. Great to see that up against the skyline.
You know what that means, right?
It's almost fireworks time.
Almost fireworks time. Stand by. We're going to be right back with more of Fiesta Fiesta from Hemisphere Park. Welcome back to KSAT 12's Fiesta Fiesta from Hemisphere Park. Right now, our Katie Blake has the coolest job, you could say. She's dancing with cows with Chick-fil-A.
I love that shot, though. Look at that shot with the tower in the background.
Oh, it's beautiful. Yeah. And pretty soon, it's going to look amazing.
It really will. Let's go to Katie Blake live now in the Chick-fil-A zone. Katie.
Good. Hey, you guys. All right, yes, we're back with Chick-fil-A here. We've got the mariachi band back. Awesome music here, and the food is still going. They're going to be giving out food until 9 o'clock tonight. And look at this. This is so cool. They have the perfect spot for you to get that perfect Instagram picture. We've got the beautiful Fiesta flowers, the lights here, so folks are having a really good time. And we were talking to Joshua, who's with Chick-fil-A, over the last hour or so. And as he mentioned, there's a lot of Fiesta events coming up over the next couple of weeks that Chick-fil-A is going to be a part of. And this is just part of how they want to be involved in their communities, each restaurant in their specific community, over the course of the year, and not just through Fiesta. I had a chance to talk to one of our local restaurant owners a few weeks back as they were preparing for Fiesta, talking all about their medals and things like that. And I believe we're going to be hearing from her here in just a bit. So we'll check back in with you guys here shortly from all the Chick-fil-A action that we have going on.
What is better than Fiesta? How about Fiesta with Chick-fil-A in hand? Oh, yeah. As you're out and about at different Fiesta events this year, including all of the parades, be on the lookout for Chick-fil-A. They'll have booths, floats, and a mobile kitchen.
We're going to sample over 8,000 sandwiches.
You heard that right. 8,000 sandwiches. Aside from the food, Chick-fil-A will also be doing some giveaways and having plenty of Fiesta fun. And of course, you'll get to meet this guy.
Yeah! Why is this so good?
Even the Chick-fil-A cow is decked out for Fiesta this year with his Como Mas Pollo sign. You'll also see the cow on this year's Chick-fil-A Fiesta medal.
Let's talk about this. This is amazing. The boots, I love that.
Now this year's medal features the cow with his Como Mas Pollo sign, sporting some sweet boots and a sombrero.
So this year's medal, we were able to establish a special cow motto, and San Antonio is the only city who gets to brag and have this special Como Mas Pollo on their logo.
You can buy a medal when you see Chick-fil-A out and about during Fiesta, or just go right to your local restaurant. However, you need to get there fast.
And you need to go fast because they're selling out quickly.
Are they really?
Yes, they really are.
When you buy this year's Chick-fil-A medal, you're not just adding a special medal to your collection. You're helping Chick-fil-A give back. A portion of the medal sales will go right back into the community.
And in the last 4 years, we've been able to donate $48,000 back to different organizations and nonprofits. So we're super excited to be able to have a platform to do that.
And even though Fiesta is a special time for the city of San Antonio and Chick-fil-A, the spirit of the party with a purpose sticks around all year long, because the money raised during medal sales this year will help each restaurant, being locally owned and operated, give back to their specific community.
We're very engaged with our local, two of our local high schools, and we do what's called Leader Academy. And it's a phenomenal program that works with high school students to develop their leadership skills. So we're teaching the young people to also give back and how to have servants' hearts. I mean, the Leader Academy really focuses on that.
And it all starts at the counter of your local Chick-fil-A restaurant when you place your order.
I think that what the community might not know is what the corporate purpose is. And the corporate purpose is to glorify God by being a faithful steward of all that we've been entrusted with and to have a positive impact on all we come in contact with. So that's our goal each and every day, is to create a remarkable experience for each and every guest.
During Fiesta and all year long. Katie Blake, KSAT 12 News.
All right, if I wasn't hungry before, I'm hungry now. Thank you, Katie, for that story, by the way.
I did give you some Chick-fil-A
you
earlier
did.
Today.
Two nuggets. The two nuggets were delicious.
All right, we'll be right back with more of your Fiesta coverage. I'll get you some more nuggets.
Thank you.
Whoa. Welcome back to our Fiesta coverage for 2019 on this beautiful evening at Hemisphere Park.
We still have live music all night long. KSAT 12 is going to show you the fabulous fireworks live this evening as well. And remember, we are the official station for Fiesta, broadcasting all of the Fiesta parades.
In fact, we want to show you, give you a flashback of how all these parades started.
The Battle of Flowers Parade started in 1891 to commemorate the Battle of the Alamo and San Jacinto. It's also considered the grandmother of all parades.
The Battle of Flowers Association is comprised completely of women volunteers, and we're the largest parade in the nation produced by women. And we're also the oldest parade in Fiesta. We are the founding event of Fiesta. The parade date is Friday, April 26th, 2019. And we're gonna have a start off time with our vanguard of 8:55 a.m. And the parade proper starts at 9:30 a.m.
In 1941, the Cavaliers kicked off their yearly river parade.
We were established in 1926 and based on three founding pillars, if you will, based on wanted to improve our relationships with the military, honor the horsemanship in the time of the invent of the automobile, and wanted to honor the fallen heroes of the Alamo.
They've been going strong, raising money for children's charities since.
We do it in the monetary form, where we donate back to our community and various charities that need our support, and we're there to support them for the kids that they foster and nourish and make sure they have a bright future.
The Fiesta Flambeau was founded in 1948 by Reynolds Andrix, where groups of men carrying torches or flambeaux help to light the way along the parade route. Today, it is the largest illuminated night parade in the nation, and it continues to attract visitors to San Antonio.
We've kept our tradition alive, illuminating the streets of San Antonio with over 750,000 people and 1.5 million people watching it and streaming on national TVs.
The Texas Cavaliers River Parade is April 22nd. It'll be showtime on the river this Monday. Then on April 26th, the Battle of Flowers Parade will dazzle the streets with glamorous royalty. And for the love of Texas, some floats will be Texas proud. Then on April 27th, Fiesta Flambeau will boogie on down Broadway, down to the Alamo, with reflections of music from the past. So get ready, San Antonio, because this year, all the parades are planning some serious entertainment you don't want to miss.
And actually, there's an opportunity to be a star during the Fiesta Flambeau Parade.
You get to be in the parade. Jen Strusky explains how it happens.
We're out here at the Pearl, where Toyota is celebrating their 11th year as the official vehicle of Fiesta and the Fiesta Flambeau Parade. Joining me, Greg Brungart, the sponsorship manager for Gulf States Toyota. And first of all, wow, 11 years.
11 years.
Why is it so important that Toyota is part of Fiesta?
You know, Fiesta is really a true reflection of what the city is all about. It brings together the culture, the philanthropic efforts, and Toyota is proud to be a part of that. You know, we've been a part of the fabric of this community for many years. Mm-hmm. Toyota Motor Manufacturing Texas opened up operations in 2006, employing thousands of men and women who proudly build this Tundra right here.
This beautiful thing here, wow.
Right,
yes.
And the Tacoma.
Yes.
And we have six area San Antonio dealers who are really excited about Fiesta this year. So that's why it's important for us to be a part of it all.
Wow, I love that response. But what are some things going on then with Toyota and the events? What can people be on the lookout for with Toyota?
Yeah, we have a lot going on this year. One of my favorites is we have a Tacoma TRD Pro that proudly says, Viva Fiesta San Antonio. You can come down uh-huh. at any of the Fiesta events that we're at. Okay. You can sign the Tacoma with your name and then put your favorite band or your favorite song on the Tacoma. Uh-huh. So that aligns with Fiesta Flambeau Parade's, their Reflections of Music past theme. Nice. And so that Tacoma is ultimately gonna be lit up in black lights and driven through the Fiesta Flambeau Parade here in a few weeks. So we're excited about that. That's gonna join 10 to 12 other trucks, Tundra and Tacomas, from our six area San Antonio dealers.
And people have a chance to register to win something big, right? Connected with that in the parade?
Right. So again this year, we are giving one person and a guest the once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to ride on the Toyota float through the Flambeau Parade. They can sign up on KSAT.com or on Fiesta website to do that. And they'll also get some tickets to the parade as well.
Awesome. And let's talk about your medal here.
Yeah, so this is the official Toyota 2019 medal.
Nice.
And you can, when you stop by and see us at different Fiesta events, you can sign up for your chance to get it. And then we also have this year our special golden Toyota medal. This is a limited edition run of these medals, so you might be the lucky one to pick up one of these as well.
And again, these are made right here in town. The Tundra, beautiful. This is a 2019 behind
2019.
Us.
Toyota Tundra, yes, built right here in San Antonio.
And the Tacomas as well. Greg, thank you so much. We hope to see you out and about, having fun responsibly, everybody. And don't forget, you can enter to win the sweepstakes right now. KSAT.com, the winner gets to ride on the Toyota float in the Fiesta Flambeau Parade. Just visit KSAT Toyota Zone page on KSAT.com and enter for your chance to win. Greg, thank you, and Viva Fiesta.
Viva Toyota.
Viva Toyota.
That is definitely a chance of a lifetime. All you have to do is log on to KSAT.com, our website, and go to KSAT.com/Fiesta, and then click on the Fiesta Zone.
Right now, the music is getting the crowd fired up. Ledez is still on stage. And the funny thing about this band is we can't see them from here, but we can feel them from here. The bass is shaking the stage that we're on right now. And the beautiful sights and sounds of all this playing out right outside Hemisphere. They've shut down the road, and you've got the Tower Life building on one side, and you've got the Tower of Americas on the other side. It's just a great scene tonight.
And the fireworks are gonna be shooting up into the sky in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.
Right now, live on stage, Texas legend, Ruben Ramos.
Kansas City, vamos a cárcel.
Ruben Ramos still on the stage at Hemisphere Park for Fiesta Fiesta. What a legend.
Yeah, you can tell people have made their way out from the park, out onto the street to the main stage. Ruben Ramos, we'll be right back.
Lots of crowd enjoying this concert. It's wall-to-wall people watching Ruben Ramos on the stage.
Yeah, they have the light sticks are going. A lot of people have their flower crowns going as well. We'll lit up. Let's listen into Ruben Ramos a little bit here.
Thank you so much. On behalf of all that dance, myself, the beginning of Fiesta, Viva Fiesta San Antonio. Por las orillas del agua del mar.
San Antonio. Let's now throw it over to Katie Blake, who is in the middle of all of this.
Hi. So there's Adam Caskey. Yes, we are still here by all the food vendors. The
party still
smells
going
so
on.
Good. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Party doesn't stop, baby. How many of those did you order? How many dozen?
40. 40 dozen.
40 dozen. 40 dozen. 40 dozen.
And let me tell you, it takes a long time at the HEB self-checkout. Beep, beep, beep. And I'm like, excuse me, Melissa, the lady working there. I'm like, can I just type the numbers? Got to do them all individually. Totally worth it.
No, you didn't. You didn't do them all individually, did you?
Yeah, I did.
Let it happen. Let it rain. Let it rain confetti. This has been such
a
great
crowd over here.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, you did. It's getting a little serious now. This has been such a great fiesta. The weather has been awesome. These folks have been fired up, and I can't wait for the next, like, week and a half. It's going to be awesome.
I've seen so many good medals out there, you know, this year. And particularly, I want to see if I can find it on here. I've got so many. All right.
Putting that down.
Check out this retro one, right?
Okay.
No, yeah, the Super Mario, okay. He jumps and he hits a taco out of the little question mark brick. Isn't that cool?
Yes, I love that.
And he goes after him.
I'm partial to this one, the car that says anything for fiestas and the bumper's off. It's a little nod to a pretty famous movie. I love that medal.
Who here can floss with me?
Oh my gosh, we're doing the flossing again. So, that's a confetti cannon. A confetti cannon. Oh my gosh. And very impressive. All right. Still going strong here at Fiesta. There's so much more to come over the next couple of weeks across San Antonio as Fiesta continues, and we hope to see you out at some of the parades and all the other Fiesta events. Guys, back over to you.
I am shaking my head at the Adam Caskey floss over there. And the funny thing is, the look in his face.
Oh, he's all into it.
He's like serious about
it. And I mean, that's what his medal is all about.
It is.
Flossing.
And yeah, he lives up to it.
He does. Okay, here's the crowd enjoying Fiesta. The music is still playing. We are getting ready for the fireworks show, which is always spectacular over the Tower of the Americas.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I can't wait to see this shot with fireworks going off as well. Ruben Ramos is still on stage, I believe. Let's listen in.
The party's gonna keep going tonight. All right.
Somebody make some noise!
Cuando te vi por primera vez, en aquel momento me hiciste feliz. Ahora me paso pensando en ti, sin olvidar tu manera de mirar. Ahora me paso pensando en ti, sin olvidar tu manera de mirar. Yolanda, Yolanda,
yo por ti me muero.
Yolanda,
sabes que te quiero.
Yolanda, que por ti me muero. Solo espero que me digas así, para no vivir desesperado. En aquel momento me hiciste feliz, las jugadoras que maté a tu lado. En aquel momento me hiciste feliz, las jugadoras que maté a tu lado. Yolanda,
sabes que te quiero.
Yolanda,
y por ti me muero.
Yolanda,
tú sabes que te quiero.
Yolanda, que por ti me muero. me digas a ti para no vivir desesperado. En aquel momento me hiciste feliz, las pocas horas que pasé a tu lado. En aquel momento me hiciste feliz, las pocas horas que pasé a tu lado. Yolanda, sabes que te quiero. Yolanda,
yo por ti me muero.
Yolanda,
sabes que te quiero.
Yolanda, que por ti me muero.
Was Ruben Ramos, Texas legend, getting the crowd going, that's for sure.
Always classy.
Yeah.
Love the way he works the audience.
Absolutely. And, you know, we are now shortly going to begin the countdown for fireworks. That's what we're waiting for here from downtown San Antonio, is the fireworks will be happening very soon.
I have to make mention that I really enjoyed this Fiesta for a number of reasons. This is, I believe, our fourth or fifth year hosting this event, and I think this was the best weather we've ever had.
It certainly is beautiful right now. What, 70s? I mean, the wind has died down. It's dark, so you get to see hats like this lit up in all their glory. And I just think back to how much this event has grown.
It has.
I mean, it used to be just exchanging pins.
And I remember talking to the person who originated the whole idea of Fiesta. They thought it would just be a little get-together. But
Look
at it now. Let's go back to the main stage where they are getting ready to make the announcements before our fireworks begin.
Good evening, San Antonio! How's everybody doing this evening? All right, so on behalf of Macy's San Antonio, we are proud and honored to be here this evening as the sponsor of Fiesta and the opening night fireworks. We are all about giving back to our community, and part of giving back to our community means making lives shine brighter. I can't think of a better way to make lives shine brighter than to have fireworks. What do you all think? Woo! So, are you all ready to get ready for the fireworks and the best part of tonight?
I'll tell you what, we're going to start at 10, and I think it's appropriate that we have Miss Fiesta San Antonio lead us in the countdown, but you all have to join in from 10.
Ready? Are y'all ready? Ready? 10.
Nope, hang on.
Oh.
Nope, not yet.
Just kidding.
It's called technical difficulties in TV land.
Sorry.
While we're waiting, Jen, do you have an update on the Spurs? Pulling up the app. You ready? Oh, okay. We can go on with the fireworks.
Okay. Now are you ready? 10. Oh.
Make it quick.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Yeah.
downtown San Antonio. Our time is almost up for Fiesta Fiesta coverage.
That's right. Fiesta Fiesta 2019 is just about over, but Fiesta itself is just beginning. We have so much coverage planned for you, including the River Parade coming up on Monday night.
That does it from Hemisphere Park for all of us at KSAT.